Today is 26th of November. Well, this is a day when back in 1949, the Constitution of India was adopted by the Constituent Assembly of India under the chairmanship of the great Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. A lot has changed in the 70 or more years of independence, but India hasn't still been able to take its name to the list of the developed countries. India still remains a developing nation. So what are the secrets of the most developed countries? What makes them stand where they are today? Well, the answer is their constitution. The policies that they have formulated and implemented is what sets them apart from us. So in this particular video, I'm going to break down three of such best laws from across the best countries that India should adopt in their quest to create a dream nation. Well, this is not just a random video, but it is completely based on mathematics and statistics. But before that, if you're watching this video with your political opinion, then this video is not for you. Please skip this right away. But this video is for that group of people who wish to see a great future of this country. So if you get any kind of value from this particular video, then please share this with your family and friends. Number 1, the free education policy of Czech Republic. Well, the Czech education system is based on a long tradition beginning in 1774 when free compulsory schooling was introduced. Children start with their preschool, elementary, secondary, university and post-graduation, and all of this is funded by government. And what was the outcome? Czech Republic currently has got the literacy rate about 99%. It has now become a developed and a first world country with some of the smartest human beings on the planet. Although free education policy is also available in India under the Right to Free and Compulsory Education Act of 2009, where children of the age from 6 to 14 are provided free education at public schools, but the quality of education at such schools has seen a major fall. As of 2020, India's literacy rate is 77.7%. There are some states in India where the percentage is below 60%, and a major increase in the crime rates is seen, which drags us behind from the path of development. I recently came across this very shocking news piece where a 6-year-old girl was raped and her liver was extracted by a couple who did not have a child. Well, the reason is that they learned from a book that eating the liver of a child will help them to beget one. This is the outcome of superstition and illiteracy. A lot of such similar cases have happened in our country, and illiteracy is the main reason. And literacy is the ray of hope that will lead us from today's darkness of superstition to tomorrow's brightness of prosperity. And tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today, and quality education is a passport to the future. Number 2, the environmental protection policies of Norway and Lithuania. Norway just became the first country in the world to ban deforestation. This means that Norwegian lawmakers will not award any government contracts to companies that take part in clear-cutting of trees for the cause of infrastructure development. At the current rate of deforestation, all the rainforest of the world might get vanished from 100 years from now on. 80% of the world's animal and plant species live in forests, and they cannot survive if they lose their habitat. India has currently seen deforestation at an alarming rate, which contributes to major problems like climate change, desertification, soil erosion, fewer crops, flooding, increased greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, and a host of problems for the indigenous people. Environmental problems are real. Another major problem is that of clean drinking water. Lithuania's tap water is the cleanest in Europe, and it is perfectly drinkable. This is because 100% of it is taken from the underground water sources, sheltered away from human interference, rather than from surface lakes or rivers, which can be easily contaminated. About 71% of the Earth's atmosphere is filled with water, and out of that only 3% is fresh and 0.3% is perfect for human usage. And it is a myth that if the Third World War ever occurs, then it is going to be for water crisis. By 2050, 1 in 5 developing countries will face water shortage. Most of the water supplied in cities are unclean, which is processed and chemical treated, and this leads to further diseases like jaundice and cholera. However, a lot of villages in India have got wells and borewells, but that percentage is decreasing. In 2017, the government of Hyderabad banned digging of borewells at over 1000 plus villages, which means that they are also moving towards the modern supply system. To achieve the next possible development, it is not necessary to forget the old ways, but it's about channelizing the old ways in the new direction. Progress is impossible without change, and those who cannot change their minds cannot change anything. Number 3, education qualifications to become a political leader policy of Singapore. As per the election department of Singapore, a person is qualified to contest an election if he has got a set of requirements along with a sufficient degree of proficiency in spoken English, Malay, Mandarin or Tamil, and he must be able to read and write one of the said languages so that he can take active part in the proceedings of the parliament. However, it is ironic that Indian political system do not have a minimum education qualification to contest elections in the country. In my opinion, a minimum qualification of a degree in some field should be mandatory. Recent reports showed that almost 50% of the Indians have had their first-hand experience in paying bribe or using contacts to get their works processed. In 2019, the Corruption Perceptions Index ranked the country 80th place out of 150 countries, indicating a steady decline. Problems like corruption, black money and poverty, which align countries' development, can be effectively tackled by able political system. And a minimum education qualification can come very handy to tackle all these problems. Our country, India, is not still a perfect nation, but it is slowly in the process of getting there. A lot of people complain that we haven't done much in the 70 or more years of independence. Some people criticize the government, while others criticize the constitution. But let us not forget that it's not the government or the constitution that makes a great nation, but the power lies in our hands. The success or failure of any nation totally depends on how civilized the people of the country are. Today, on our 71st Constitution Day, let us burn all our differences, be it religious, social or political, and let us come together to build that dream nation where peace, harmony and prosperity coexist. Happy National Constitution Day!